Imagine a restaurant. A customer places an order with the waiter. The waiter then takes note of the order, goes to the kitchen, and brings back what was requested to the customer. Well, the role of a web server is exactly the same, but instead of taking orders for food, it takes requests for web pages. Indeed, a web server is a server that stores and publishes web pages, usually written in HTML, but also all files constituting a website, such as images, CSS style sheets, and JavaScript files. The web server process is an example of the client-server model, handling requests in the HTTP protocol. If you're not familiar with the concept of the HTTP protocol, I invite you to check out my dedicated video on the subject. When you open your web browser and type in a website address, your browser is like the customer placing an order. It requests a web page from the web server, which responds by sending the requested page. Besides HTTP, web servers also support SMTP, for Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, to send and receive emails, but also FTP, or File Transfer Protocol, used for file transfers. Apache HTTP Server and Nginx are examples of widely used open-source web servers. In a common setup, a website serving both static and dynamically generated content employs web servers for static data and application servers for dynamic content generation. Web servers handle HTTP requests, delivering web content, while application servers host and generate dynamic content based on user requests. Application servers create interactive website components. In application servers, we have, for example, Apache Tomcat or Wildfly, formerly JBoss. Yet, server roles are increasingly converging. Apache and Nginx now offer a hybrid of both. To delve deeper into the subject, I invite you to check out my dedicated video on the application server. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the upcoming videos. Goodbye.